You can remote control Microsoft Windows and Apple macOS devices that have an Ivanti Endpoint Manager agent. In the network view, devices you can remote control have a remote control overlay on them. It looks like a TV remote. There are many remote control agent settings you can customize. Click Configuration, Agent Settings. Under Remote Control, double-click an existing agent setting or right-click and click New. Among many other things, you can modify settings such as what users see when they're being remote controlled and whether or not they must grant permission to be remote controlled. To remote control a device, right-click it and click Remote Control. The starting remote control overlay appears, and it may take several seconds for the session to start. If permission is required at the endpoint, the user will be asked if they want to allow the remote control session. The user has 30 seconds to allow or deny the request. Once the session starts, if the remote user is logged in, you will see their screen. If nobody is logged in, you will see the remote login screen and you will need to log in with your domain administrator credentials or something similar. During remote control, a pop-up remote control notification displays in the bottom right corner of the targeted device while the session is active. Move this notification if it's in the way. Use the toolbar buttons at the bottom to transfer files, remotely run programs, toggle resolution scaling, or toggle full screen mode. To finish a remote control session, click Close on the toolbar. Remote Control also has a standalone console that supports both Windows and macOS. This is useful for help desk analysts or other administrators who don't have an Endpoint Manager console installed. The standalone Remote Control console is a single executable file that is located here on the core server. You can copy this file to any computer that you want. When you run it, you'll see the Remote Control WS Viewer login page. The console has an interactive console mode or direct connection mode. You must provide Endpoint Manager credentials and have remote control permissions to start a remote control session. Once you're logged in, you can use the global search box or one of the individual column search boxes to filter results. Clicking a device shows its details. Click the Connect button to start a remote control session.